In fact, we live in a society where there are a lot of implicit beliefs which are not questioned anymore, and we are facing a convergence of crises. I will call it a crisis of civilization or anthropological crisis, where you have this economic, financial crisis on one hand, you have this environmental, energetic crisis on the other hand, and in the middle you have all this cultural, political, social crisis. And we need really to decolonize our imagination, as I said yesterday. It means that we need to go deeper in questioning a lot of beliefs, like the beliefs in economics, the religion of economics, the beliefs in the progress, the beliefs in development, the belief in growth, that growth will provide always more well-being, and to start to redefine the lines of a new model of society, a new paradigm, and to question how can we be able to make a transition from this growth society, from this development society, which accumulates all these crises, which doesn't make the people happy anymore, which is driving us to an environmental war, environmental wall, and to a big collapse, and how to go from this society to a new model of society, what we will have to redefine to. How can we relocalize our production? How can we relocalize our local economic alternative system? How can we change totally the relationship we have with each other, the relation to power, relation to production, to the tool, to the nature? And to go ahead, we should really, really decolonize our imagination.
How would you do that? I mean, how can you do that?
So it starts with a deep debate to understand. I think as Einstein said, that if you have a hammer in your head, you see all the problem looking like a nail. And I think one of the hammer we have nowadays in our head is really the religion of economics. So we are really like homo economicus. We see all the problem from an economic point of view. And in fact, what we have to understand, and it's a step of decolonization of our imagination, of our economic imagination, what we have to understand that economics is just a science, and it's a abstraction. It's something which was created. It's what you can see, for example, with that economic debt. In the name of this economic debt, we are destroying what is making a society. We are with austerity plans just to save an economic system. We are destroying the school, we are destroying the health system, we are destroying the culture, we are destroying the politics, we are destroying the democracy. We are sending the police, like in Greece, to fight against the big demonstrations. And we also push people to be totally desperate. Like in Greece and in Italy, there were a huge increase of suicides. People are committing suicide because they are losing everything. And we should understand that the problem is not to save something which was created by humans. The problem is to solve what is this crisis of civilization. Some people are speaking about eco-socialism. I will speak about degrowth. You can speak about transition, we can speak about the buen vivir, like they say in Ecuador, for example. I mean, we are a society of enjoyment of life, as Georges Kouroghan said, one of the fathers of the degrowth thinking. And it's really to redefine what do we produce, how do we produce it, and for what kind of use, and to reappropriate locally some type of autonomy, some type of democratic choices. And we should totally get rid of our dependency on oil and all this technostructure, all this mega machine, which is a very complex system. The best example is really a big city. It's a very complex system where every morning millions of people are waking up and are going to go to work to make this system not collapse. And a city is something where if you stop importing oil, in a couple of days everybody is starved to death. And in the same way, you have this agriculture system, which is totally depending on oil. We have intensive agriculture models where from the beginning to to our plate, we need a lot of oil with the fertilizers, with pesticides, with the tractors that we have to feed with oil, and after you have all the conditionment of the food, the transport of the food, and finally it goes to a supermarket and you take your car to buy it. So we should totally break all this craziness and to relocalize the production, in particular food, energy, public services. Just behind we have like a bike shop. And it's something we should develop everywhere, to reappropriate locally the tools, how to repair our washing machine, how to construct a bike, or recycle a bike, how to recycle the things, how to produce in a city and as a countryside locally the food. And it's what we call an open relocalization. So we should relocalize as well, because it has a lot of very positive benefits, social benefits, cultural benefits. we have a more intense, convivial way of life. We have a real democracy, because a real democracy is only possible in a small scale with communities where everybody knows each other. So we should really, really get rid of this model of society, this ideology of development and growth and economics and productivism and capitalism and consumerism and everything, which are really, really eating us from inside, to create a new type of society when we put in the heart of the society sustainability and a type of desirability. I think we have like a matrix of recipes. Somehow, the change is already going on. There are young people everywhere, not only young, a lot of people everywhere in Western societies, in Hungary as well, in France where I'm from. Some people who start to initiate, to start to experiment new ways of life, who start to launch, for example, locally a community garden, to initiate a project around permaculture, to initiate a transition to movement, to initiate, to implement alternative, non-speculative local currency. And all these initiatives are participating to an ongoing transition, but it won't be enough. We should also think individually what makes us very happy. So it's what we call voluntary simplicity, that we should question our relationship with the work, with the consumption, with the tools, with the other people. How do we interact with each other? Our relationship to power. We should decolonize our imagination. We should also participate to politics, I think, participate to election, not to get elected, not to, with an ideology that it would be enough to take the power to change the society, but to use this political stage to spread some ideas, to participate to some debates, to make people meet each other, to create local groups of people who after can initiate some project. And we should also have a deep work, intellectual work, academic work on the project. What could be tomorrow sustainable and desirable new models of societies that we want to create? And I put it in plural because it won't be one unique dogma which will be applied everywhere, but really as many models as communities recreated and depending on the local situation, on the local tradition, the local language, culture, on the local environment and stuff like that, and how to make this transition, how step by step we can implement this transition. We are quite in a bad situation concerning the time. We are already facing a huge crisis, but there is no other solution. I mean, we are really facing what we call degrowth of barbaria, and we are also facing what we call a chosen degrowth, so a social transition, a forced recession. And the forced recession has already started. Forced recession. It has already started. And but what we can see, like in it's quite interesting in Greece, we can start to see like a convergence between a chosen degrowth, so people who initiated this type of alternative projects or who started to decolonize their imagination, started to think about degrowth, to think about transition, to think about sustainability and what could be a society of enjoyment of life, of when we are. They are joined by people who are suffering so much from the austerity plans, who are put in misery, that they don't have any other choice to reappropriate locally their production, their economic system and their tools. And what would be the best is to avoid this part where people are suffering from recession and to immediately initiate a transition, which could be a democratic, a sovereign transition, and not this catastrophe, which is this forced recession, which is totally pushed by a totally crazy technocrats from Brussels and the big banks. And these technocrats are totally like believers in economics, like we used to believe in religions. And these technocrats are just serving the interests of a big oligarchy.